Hi, good morning guys. So in this class I am going to continue the lipid metabolism. So in previous class we have seen some basic introduction and fatty oxidation process, different types of fatty oxidation process, alpha beta oxidation, beta oxidation and omega fatty acid oxidation. So in this class I am going to take in the ketone bodies, ketogenesis and ketolysis process. So before that I want to make a small recap to grasp the today session. So introduction, we have seen what is the lipids, how much the it's why it's considered as a fuel reservoir, it because it's having a more amount of energy when compared to the glycogens, and different types of phospholipids we have seen. Then transport of lipids, if it is combined with protein, it's called as a lipoprotein, it's going to transport in the blood systemic circulation. Then reference value, and it's, we know that it's a normal dynamic role of lipids because it's going to mobilize from the liver and from the small intestine, it's enter into the adipose tissue. It's once again is going to cycle from the adipose, it's once again is enter into the liver. So it's having a one of the dynamic role. This we can see in previous classes. Then mobilization, that means nothing but the triglycerides undergoing the lipolysis process is produce the free fatty acid and glycerol with the influence of various hormones. So example, epinephrine and glucagon, all those things, and insulin and such kind of substance is going to inhibit the lipolysis process. These things also we have discussed in previous class. So the next one is two product we have formed. One is glycerol, another one is fatty acids. So the fatty acids undergoing the fatty acid oxidation process for energy production purpose. In remaining, the glycerol is also is enter into the various process. The glycerol is going to phosphorylated, is converted into the glycerol 3-phosphate. It's capable to going for two way. One is triglyceride synthesis. Once again, is enter into the triglyceride biosynthesis process. Otherwise, is enter into the glycolysis process via dihydroxyacetone phosphate, intermediate substance. So the fatty acids, metabolic disease we have seen, Wolfman disease. So the triglyceride fatty acid is continuously is going to form and degrade. So it's a cycle. So it's called as triglycerol and fatty acid cycle. So next we have seen fatty acid oxidation process. Three important oxidation we have seen: alpha, beta and omega oxidation. So the first one is very important one is beta oxidation. So three process, beta oxidation containing three process: activation of fatty acid, transport and exact oxidation process. So in activation, nothing but the fatty acid is converted into the acyl-CoA. It's a two-step reaction. So with the help of ATP and coenzyme. In second step, the transport mechanism, the acyl-CoA, it must be enter into the mitochondria, but as such, it's can't able to enter inside the mitochondria because it's a impermeable membrane of mitochondria. So it's enter into the mitochondria through carnitine cycle. The carnitine palmitoyl transferase enzyme 1 and 2, it's responsible for this process. So carnitine 1 is responsible for entry into the mitochondria. So carnitine palmitoyl transferase enzyme 2, it's responsible for free of acyl-CoA. So for next step, the next step is beta oxidation. It's having four different steps. First one is oxidation. Oxidation in beta carbon, alpha carbons is going to remove the hydrogen ions. The second one is hydration. Addition of water molecule is going to, in beta carbon, is going to addition of hydroxyl ions and hydrogen ions. So in third step, once again, is going to oxidize. So it's going to remove the hydrogen ions. In fourth step with the help of thiolase enzyme, the beta keto acyl CoA is going to cleave into 2-acetyl-CoA. So this is the process. So this is a net reactions. So next we have seen alpha oxidation. This is nothing but the fatty acid oxidation is going to happen in alpha carbon, means it's called as alpha oxidation. So it is not predominant one because mostly it's never going to this pathway. So if in some rare genetic disorder, the alpha oxidation is going to fail due to the lack of the phytic acid alpha oxidase enzyme. That enzyme is responsible for oxidation of alpha carbon atom in phytic acid. So it's mostly present on the chlorophyll substance, green leaf vegetables. So the patients is can't able to metabolize the phytic acid. So we can inform to the patients, don't take the green leaf vegetables. That's a thing. It's a one kind of cerebral central nervous system neurological disorder. So the phytic acid is going to accumulate, means it's lead to neurological defects. So that's the reason we can inform to the person, no need to take a green leaf vegetables. Okay, so the next one is omega oxidation. So this oxidation process is going to happen totally is different. It's going to happen on the co-carbon atom. So in next we have seen in the metabolic water, particularly some animals, camel and kangaroo rat is capable to produce metabolic water. It's one of the very good phenomena for survival in extreme condition. So in this class, I am going to explain about the ketone bodies. So up to now we have seen acetyl-CoA formation. So the first triglycerides are, it's undergoing the lipolysis process. It's going to produce fatty acids and glycerol. So glycerol is going to the recycling process. The fatty acid is undergone the oxidation process. So at the end of oxidation process is going to produce the acetyl-CoA. That's right. So now we are going to start with acetyl-CoA. So once this acetyl-CoA is available, what is going to be, how it's going to convert it into the other product, means here that's the answer. So the acetyl-CoA is converted into the ketone bodies. Okay, so we have seen in detail about in further slides. So first we can see what is ketogenesis and what is ketolysis. So as I said earlier, so once the fatty acid oxidation, once this fatty acid is going to oxidize, means it's going to produce the acetyl-CoA. So this acetyl-CoA is going to combine together, it's going to form a ketone bodies. Ketone bodies means it's having some unique substance. We can see in next slide. So it's going to form a ketone bodies. The ketone bodies are capable to produce energy. So in previous cycle, you just remember that the fatty acid is it's capable to produce energy for most of the cell except brain and RBC, because brain is mostly a glucose as a energy resource. If it is glucose is not available, its second choice is ketone bodies. So the fatty acid can't directly involve the energy production in brain, but the acetyl-CoA, through acetyl-CoA, it's converted into the ketone bodies. Those ketone bodies is capable to produce the energy for brain. Okay, so it's also an energy yielding substance. The parallelly, once the ketone bodies is going to form, it's enter into the systemic circulation, it may carry out into the various place. When the energy is need particular place, that place the ketone bodies is going to involve the reaction, is going to once again is going to degrade, it's going to produce the energy. It's going to produce once again acetyl-CoA. That acetyl-CoA is enter into the TCA cycle, it's going to produce energy for peripheral tissue. So that is overall reaction. So from the acetyl-CoA, excess amount of acetyl-CoA is there, means it's converted into the energy compounds, that is ketone bodies. The ketone bodies is may travel from the various place through bloodstream. So when our body needs energy in peripheral level or brain, so the ketone bodies is capable to produce the energy. It's going to degrade, it's going to produce acetyl-CoA, enter into the TC cycle, it's produce the energy. So that is the major overview of ketogenesis and ketolysis process. So next we can go for what is ketone bodies. The ketone bodies means it's namely three substances in our body is having three ketone bodies. One is acetone, the second one is acetoacetate, the third one is beta hydroxybutyrate. These are the three substances it's called as are considered as a ketone bodies. Unfortunately, the first two substances, acetones or acetoacetates, are ketones, but the beta hydroxybutyrate does not possess the keto group. So you can see the structure, it's having a keto group, but in beta hydroxybutyrate it doesn't have a keto group. So it's having one of the unique physical properties. Ketone bodies are easily water soluble. That's the reason it's produced energy, it's becoming energy yielding substance. So acetone, even though it's acetone is considered as a ketone bodies, is normally we are not considered as acetone as a major source, so it's an exemption. So mostly the acetostate or beta hydroxybutyrate this act as a true ketone bodies. So we can go for the outline diagram cycle. So first the fatty acid, it's oxidized, means it's produced the acetyl CoA from this cycle. From the fatty acid means it's going to produce the acetyl CoA. If it is glucose, means from the glycogen, it's undergoing the glycogenolysis, produce the glucose. The glucose is enter into the various pathway, it's produce the acetyl CoA as a end product. So the finally the acetyl CoA is going to form from the either in glucose material or fatty acid material. So after that, this acetyl CoA, it's two ways are, either it's directly enter into the Krebs cycle for the energy production purpose, for various places, skeletal muscles or heart, for various purpose. Otherwise, this acetyl CoA, it's may converted into the ketone bodies. That ketone bodies, it's essential to produce the energy for brain. That's a reason. So the because the fatty acid, it's as such is can't able to produce the energy, so it must be converted into the ketone bodies, means the ketone bodies easily travel through the bloodstream, it's enter into the brain, it's capable to produce the energy for brain. That's a mechanism. So this is overall summary of ketone body synthesis and utilization and excretion. So you can see here I have divided into three different compartment: liver and blood and the intrahepatic tissue. So in liver, so you can see the fatty acid is going to oxidize, is converted into the acetyl CoA. The acetyl CoA is enter into the TC cycle, means it produces energy. Otherwise, is converted into the ketone bodies. Those ketone bodies is watery soluble nature, so it's easily enter into the systemic circulation. So if the fatty acids, we know that the fatty acid is easily transported in the blood because it's going to bound with the albumin, so it's available in blood. So the fatty acid either directly enter into the tissue for energy production, otherwise the fatty acid is undergoing the liver for the oxidation process. So the ketone bodies, as usual, the fatty acid is converted into the ketone bodies, means the ketone bodies is enter into the blood circulation. So in blood circulation, it may eliminated in two ways, through kidney or lungs. So the ketone bodies is eliminated through respiration also. Mostly it's eliminated through urine. Then apart from that, if it is in from the blood circulation, it's enter into the specific place where the place is need the energy. So the ketone bodies directly is going to the cell, it's produce the acetyl CoA. The acetyl CoA is enter into the TC cycle, energy production is going to happen. Otherwise the fatty acids also is enter into the particular tissue, muscle, so it's going to produce the energy. So this is overall summary and utilization and excretion of ketone bodies. So next we can go for exact ketogenesis process, that means formation of ketone bodies. So the ketogenesis process mostly is happen in the liver. The acetyl CoA is going to generate, so the acetyl CoA is going to become a ketone bodies in liver. So enzyme ketone body synthesis is located in the mitochondrial matrix. We know that acetyl CoA is a basic raw material. So you can see here, this is just a starting material, acetyl CoA. Two molecule of acetyl CoA, it's going to combine together. It's finally it's converted into the acetone and beta hydroxybutyrate, otherwise acetoacetate. These are three things is considered as a ketone bodies. The predominant one is acetostate, otherwise beta hydroxybutyrate. So you can see here, this is overall cycle. So we can divide this cycle in half. So this one is ketogenesis. The right one is ketogenesis, left one is ketolysis. So you can see here outline diagram. Acetyl CoA is converted into the acetoacetyl CoA. Then it's become a HMG CoA. The second next is converted into the acetoacetate. So now it's become a ketone bodies. This acetostate is once again is converted into the beta hydroxybutyrate. So up to this step, the process called as ketogenesis. So first acetyl CoA is going to combine, so it's converted into a acetoacetyl CoA, then HMG CoA, then acetoacetate, then beta hydroxy butyrate. So this process, entire thing is going to happen on the liver. So once the ketone bodies is formed, means it's entered into the blood circulation. So it's once again is going to degrade. So beta hydroxy butyrate is converted into the acetoacetate. It's produced the acetoacetyl CoA, then it's converted into the acetyl CoA. So this is entire cycle. One side in liver is going to generate the ketone bodies, in tissue is going to reverse. So this is the overall cycle. So in ketogenesis, we can see in step by step reaction. The first step, two molecules of acetyl CoA, it's going to attach together, it's going to form a acetoacetyl CoA. So you can see here in structure wise, the same molecule up to here, the two molecules of acetyl CoA, it's going to attach together. So the coenzyme, one coenzyme is attached with acetoacetyl, another one is going to remove. Okay, structure wise, the two molecules is conjoined together, one coenzyme has been removed. So this reaction is catalyzed by beta keto thiolase enzyme. That's a first step. In second step, the acetoacetyl CoA, the second step, the acetoacetyl CoA, it's converted into the HMG CoA. So this reaction is catalyzed by HMG CoA synthase enzyme. So in previous step, the acetoacetyl CoA is formed. So with the help of HMG CoA synthase enzyme, you can see here the structure wise difference. So it's converted into the HMG CoA. That's a difference. So the same area up to here, the same thing is there. So addition of this acetyl group is going to attach. So the substances become HMG CoA. The third one is the HMG CoA, it's converted into the acetoacetate. So in previous step, the HMG CoA is formed. So the next step, the HMG CoA lyase enzyme, it's going to remove the acetyl CoA. So it's become the acetoacetate. Okay, that is third step. First one is acetoacetyl CoA form. Second one is HMG CoA form. Third one is acetoacetate. Acetoacetate itself, it's a ketone bodies, but it's once again it's capable to convert in two different ketone body substance. So this acetoacetate, it's converted into the two product, either acetone or beta hydroxy butyrate with two different enzymes. So the acetoacetate is spontaneously is converted into the acetone by the removal of carbon dioxide. In parallelly, the acetoacetate has been remove the one hydrogen ion. So it's going to oxidize, it's going to remove the one hydrogen ion, it's become a beta hydroxy butyrate. So this is overall ketogenesis process. The first one is two acetyl CoA is going to form, it's become a acetoacetyl CoA. The second one is HMG CoA. The third one is HMG lyase is going to act. So it's going to form a acetoacetate. The fourth one is acetoacetate is converted into the either acetone, one side spontaneously by removal of carbon dioxide. The second side, it's hydrogen is going to happen. Addition of removal of hydrogen ions is converted into the beta hydroxy butyrate. So this is ketogenesis process. So this is overall reaction you can see here, MST wise. So two acetyl CoA is conjoined together with the help of thiolase enzyme. So it's become a acetoacetyl CoA. Then second step is converted into a HMG CoA with the help of HMG CoA synthase enzyme. So guys, you have remember this, the HMG CoA, it's directly enter into the biosynthesis of lipids also, cholesterol biosynthesis. So in that unit we have details in, but you just remember this HMG CoA is an intermediate step. From this step, we can able to synthesize the cholesterol. So this HMG CoA, it's downregulated, it's converted into the acetoacetate with the help of HMG CoA lyase enzyme by removal of one acetoacetyl group. So once the acetoacetate is formed, it's converted into two byproduct. Either it's continuous spontaneous reaction of acetone by removal of carbon dioxide. Parallelly, the addition of addition of hydrogen ions, it's become a beta hydroxy butyrate. Okay, so this is overall reaction. So apart from fatty acid, some of the amino acids, you can see here, some of the amino acids also it's produce a ketone bodies. So the those amino acids degrade means it's directly produce the acetoacetates, therefore it's become a ketone bodies. Thus amino acids are leucine, lysine and phenylalanine. These are the three amino acids it's capable to produce the ketone bodies. So the next one is ketolysis. Now with the synthesis over, then next how it's going to utilize. So as I said earlier, these are ketone bodies are watery soluble substance. So it's easily dissolved in water, so it's enter into the systemic circulation, so it's enter into the various places. So this ketone bodies, acetoacetate and beta hydroxy butyrate, these are the two ketone bodies. It serves as a important source of energy for peripheral tissue. So in case glucose is not available, means that time the ketone bodies is produce the energy, such as the important customers are skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle and renal cortex. So these are the things, is these are the organs is continuously use the ketone bodies. So the example of the erythrocyte doesn't have a mitochondria, so it can't able to utilize the ketone bodies. So here you must to know the condition. In diabetes condition, the ketone body production is more, at the same time the utilization also is less. So the diabetic condition, glucose is can't able to utilize by skeletal muscle, so it's undergoing this process, so it's going to produce more amount of ketone bodies. And apart from that, during starvation condition also, it's the ketone bodies is going to produced. Yeah, in starvation condition the ketone bodies are, it's act as a major fuel source, and fuel source for brain also. We said already the ketone bodies is capable to produce the energy for brain. So the ketone bodies can meet 50 to 70% of brain energy needs. So here metabolism, utilization of ketone bodies. So once you have studied the ketogenesis process, you can easily write the ketolysis process, because it's totally reversed. You can see here the first one is beta hydroxy butyrate is formed. So it's going to dehydrogenation, that means it's going to remove the hydrogen ions, it's become the acetoacetate. Then thioporase enzyme, the enzyme is responsible for the formation of acetyl-CoA, because the acetoacetate is going to downregulated, is converted into the acetoacetyl-CoA, okay, with the help of thioporase enzyme. So thioporase enzyme, it's convert the acetoacetate into acetoacetyl-CoA. Then last, thiolase enzyme is responsible for cleavage of acetoacetyl-CoA. So finally, it's going to act on the acetoacetyl-CoA. It's going to produce 2-acetyl-CoA. So the acetyl-CoA is now ready. So it's enter into the TCA cycle. It's produce energy. So in this reaction, the thioporase enzyme, thiolase enzyme, these are the two enzymes. It's very, very essential for ketolysis process. So overproduction, as I said earlier, normal level, the ketone bodies level, in normal condition, the ketone bodies levels are too low. So even you check in normal urine level, means its level is less than 1 mg per deciliter. It's a trace amount. It can't able to detect also by test. But in some cases, in starvation condition, otherwise in diabetic conditions, what's happened? The ketone bodies level is too high. So the condition is called as ketonemia. So the excess amount of ketone bodies in blood circulation means it's called as ketonemia. So the excess amount of ketone bodies is there, means it must be eliminated through urine. So if it is ketone bodies present on urine, means it's called as ketonuria. So in blood circulation, plasma level is more, means ketonemia. Urine means ketonuria. So various reason is there. So in overall picture, the ketonemia or ketonuria are, it's referred as a ketosis. Simply it's referred as a ketosis. Okay, either ketonemia or ketonuria. So in such case, you can feel the breath of the patient is become acetone small, because we know that the ketone bodies is eliminated through respiration. So the breath is become acetonated smell is there. So that's a condition, ketosis condition. The mostly it's we have seen in diabetic patient. So in apart from that, in starvation condition also, during starvation we doesn't having a glucose for instant energy. Glycogen also it's not capable to produce for energy for long time. So that time the fatty acid is undergoing the metabolism reaction, so it's produce the more amount of acetyl-CoA. The acetyl-CoA is enter into the ketogenesis process, so it's enter for more amount of ketogenesis, ketone bodies. So normally in diabetes condition, so the acetyl-CoA is formed means it must be enter into the TCA cycle. But unfortunately in TCA cycle we need oxaloacetate. So that's a material for the combination material for TCA cycle. But for diabetes condition, the oxaloacetate is not available, means automatically the excess amount of acetyl-CoA is enter into the ketone bodies productions. So that's a reason for overproduction. So in some weight loss program, so what they have done, they have reduced the diet. So based upon the ketonuria conditions, they have monitor when how much diet is capable to produce ketonuria. That means they are reduced the diet up to when the ketone bodies is coming through urine. That means that amount of food is sufficient for your normal work. Remaining work is carried out by your body by the ketone bodies utilization. That means your fat is going to lipolysis process, the ketogenesis is going to formation. That ketone bodies is going to utilized for your basal metabolic workout. So it must be eliminated through urine. So they have found, okay, you have sufficient this much amount of food, then only your body fat is has been utilized for energy purpose. So it's act as a wonderful tool for the fix the diet control for some weight loss programs. So in diabetes condition, I said in due to the insulin deficiency reason, we know that the lipolysis process, it's controlled by insulin. The insulin is directly is going to inhibit the lipolysis process. But in diabetic condition, insulin is not available in sufficient amount. So the lipolysis process is going to happen. So lipolysis means more amount of acetyl-CoA. Acetyl-CoA must be converted to the TCA cycle. In diabetes case, TCA cycle also is not going to possible. So the acetyl-CoA is continuously converted into the ketone bodies. So the blood circulation, the ketone bodies level is enormously is going to high. Example, up to 500 mg per day also is going to synthesized. Air is going to synthesize and eliminate through urine. So the plasma level also is going to reach up to 100 mg per deciliter. So in this condition, sometimes excess amount of condition is the person's diabetic patients going to become a ketoacidosis. So it's lead to the coma also. So we have seen next slide. So in non-pathological ketosis condition, sometime you have taken more amount of fatty food, means that time also it's undergoing the oxidation process, you can get the same scenario, ketoacidosis. So the regulation of ketogenesis. So the ketone body formation, utilization, it must be a mutual terms. So how much amount of ketone bodies is going to form, that much amount of ketone bodies has been utilized. So it must be regulated. So once the excessive amount of utilization of fatty acid means that much of amount of energy is must be utilized. So how much body your cells need energy, that much amount of fatty acid is going to oxidize, is producing ketone bodies, that ketone bodies is utilized for energy. So it must be regulated. So we know that some hormones, example we have seen in insulin, the same manner here glucagon and insulin, it's involve the regulation of ketogenesis process. Example, the glucagon and insulin, the glucagon is going to stimulate the ketogenesis process, but in insulin is going to inhibit the ketogenesis process. So normally it must be maintained, the ketone body production and the ketolysis process is going to maintain. But in some cases, due to fluctuation of either glucagon or insulin, the level is going to alter. The particularly in insulin deficiency diabetic condition, it's more amount of ketone bodies is going to form, it's become very dangerous condition for those patients also. So normally it's regulated by three things. First one is mobilization. excess, more amount of free fatty acid is mobilized from adipose tissue to from liver means automatically is going to oxidize, is produce acetyl-CoA, acetyl-CoA is converted into the ketogenesis, it's become one problem. The second one is carnitine transferase enzyme, palmitoyl transferase enzyme, because that enzyme is responsible for the transport of fatty acid in the form of acetyl-CoA from cytosol into mitochondria. So that enzyme is also responsible. The third one is concentration of oxaloacetate. So we know that the oxaloacetate is one of the combination product in TCA cycle. So the acetyl-CoA is combined with oxaloacetate, so it's enter into the TCA cycle. But in such case, in some condition, the oxaloacetate is not available, means that's also one of the substance. It's lead to acetyl-CoA enter into the ketogenesis process. So these are the three things is very, very important. Hormone means insulin glucagon, substance wise means mobilization and the transferase enzyme and oxaloacetate. So this is the condition. So apart from that, ketogenic and anti-ketogenic substance, I said already some of the amino acids, example leucine, lysine, tyrosine, phenylalanine, these are the substance amino acids. It's capable to produce the ketone bodies. The same manner in some of the amino acids, it acts as an anti-ketogenic substance. That means it's going to inhibit the ketogenesis process. Example, glycine, alanine, and serine and glutamate. So ketoacidosis condition. So I said in ketosis, normally the ketone bodies is present in either ketonemia or ketonuria, means it's called as ketosis. So excess amount of ketone bodies is present means it's acidic in nature. So it's going to reduce the pH value. So it's converted into the acidic condition. So the it's lead to the ketoacidosis. So normally it's occur in diabetic patients. I said in early what is the reason. So if it is excess amount of ketone bodies, that means it's become ketoacidosis. Diabetic condition means it's called as diabetic ketoacidosis. It's very, very dangerous. If it is the person is not taking sufficient amount of insulin, means immediately the person has become coma, even may produce death also. The ketosis may also due to the starvation, but it's not that much is possible. Mostly it's affect the diabetes cases. So what's the treatment for ketoacidosis means? Rapid treatment is very, very, very mandatory. So try to correct the metabolic abnormalities. Either we can give the associate with the water and electrolyte imbalance. The major one is we can immediately administer the insulin. Because once insulin is available, means it's going to inhibit the lipolysis process. Ketone bodies production is going to reduce. Ketoacidosis also is going to reduce. So that is overall concept. So here itself, I can wind up the session. So in next class, we can see some other concept. Thank you.